heard something. Now something had to make it. I heard a noise, boy.
You're scared, aren't you?
You bet I am, Kid Plenty.
Don't worry, Packey. We'll be okay.
Well, you'll be okay if we split up.
What?
Mikey, now you listen to me. I want you to go out there, and the first cop you see, I want you to grab him, and he'll see that you get home safe, okay?
But Packey...
Mikey, they're not after you. These guys are after me.
Well, what are you gonna do?
I'll be okay. The important thing is for you to be safe, okay? Now go on, go
no,
on.
No,
Mikey,
I'm not
you gotta
going.
Go!
No, I wouldn't leave you before and I won't now. I'm gonna stay here and protect you.
How are we doing?
Very well. There's already $750,000 in escrow. You can transfer it to the corporate account anytime you like.
Fine.
You want to do it now?
Do what?
Is anything wrong?
No. Oh, I'm sorry. It's nothing to do with business. It's sort of a personal thing. So.
Oh, I understand.
Don't touch it.
I beg your pardon?
The money in the escrow account. Leave it right where it is.
But isn't that a decision that both you and Miss Sutton should make?
Maybe. I'll have to do for now. I want the money left right where it is. Holly.
Hi.
Why haven't you checked in with us?
I've been out.
For 2 days?
Darling, are you all right?
Much better, Father.
Oh, I'm glad. I hope our little venture here isn't interfering with your vacation.
Basil, I needed to get away and...
And jeopardize our entire plan here? What do you think we're doing, playing games?
What do you call it?
Unprofessional, immature, and stupid. Basil, stop. She needs discipline, Charles. If your absence has affected our plans, I intend to see you suffer for it.
I am now, darling. But I must admit you gave me quite a scare.
I didn't mean to.
I was really worried about you.
I'm sorry, but I had to be alone for a while. I needed to clear my mind.
You had a job to do.
Had?
And it hasn't been accomplished.
No harm was done.
You were supposed to get Spencer to move the money out of escrow and into the corporate account. Clearly you couldn't, so you decided to run rather than face up to your failure.
Basil, that's enough.
It's all right, Father.
No, it's not.
You want, Basil?
Answers.
All you have to do is ask.
All right. Have you had a quarrel with Spencer?
Of course not. I left because I needed time to think.
It's too late for second thoughts, cousin.
If I'd have had them, would I have come back?
Let go of her, Basil. Now!
Can you handle it, Charles?
Father, I wouldn't let you down.
Darling, I know that. It's not myself I'm worried about.
Oh, this is all very touching. But suppose you get back and do what you're supposed to be doing.
I intend to.
Yes, get back to the Star. You're bound to have been missed. And see if you can apply that razor wit to come up with a reasonable explanation as to where you've been.
I already have.
Oh, I know. You've been out clearing your head.
I'll call you later, Father.
No, darling, I'll see you out.
Father, what's the matter?
It's just a slight dizzy spell, darling. You go on.
I'm not going anywhere.
You will. You will be the third to know.
After you and, so you will consult with Miss Sutton?
Well, of course, we're partners. That's what partners do.
When do you think you might be seeing her?
I'm not sure. She's on business quite a lot. But, there won't be any problem, I'm sure. We'll work it out. I want the decision to stand as is. The escrow account stays as is.
As you wish.
Okay. Listen, I'll talk to Van Gelder, and then I'll let you know what the next step is.
Okay. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Mr. Bell.
Hiya, Lou.
Hey, Black. You okay?
Yeah.
Funerals are a drag, aren't they?
Yeah. This one was kind of nice, though.
Yeah? Yeah. It was just you?
Yeah, it was. It's the only private moment me and my mom ever had together.
Well, that's good. It's important that you had that time. It'll make your rest easier.
I haven't been sleeping too much lately.
Yeah. You know, when you lose somebody that you love, it doesn't matter how tough you are, pal, or how independent. It hurts.
I guess you've been there,
huh? Oh, pal, sooner or later, we all go there.
Does it ever stop hurting?
Time helps.
I don't think I'm ever going to get over this.
Yes, you will. I mean, you'll never forget it. But you'll learn to live with it.
I don't know.
I know. I know you will, because you have to.
Yeah. It just really hurts me, man.
I know, and I'm not much help right now, am I, pal?
No, you are. It's just that, we were closer when she was dying than when she was alive.
You feeling a little guilty?
I'm feeling a lot guilty.
Yeah, I know. It'll take a while before you'll stop thinking of all the things you should have said or done when she was alive.
I know, I had a lot of things to tell her. I had a lot of things to straighten out. I thought we'd be together forever, that's all, and we weren't.
I bet you she knew a lot more than you thought she did.
How can I be sure of that?
You can't.
Yeah. Well, thanks.
Yeah, well, I'm never too much good in these situations, but if you need a friend, you know, or if you need a punching bag,
I'll be right here.
Okay. Something else on your mind?
No.
Talk about it, man. Come on.
I need some help.
Hey, you got it.
You don't even know what it is.
It doesn't matter.
Man, the funeral cost me $800. I left the guy $50. I need $750 more.
No problem.
Well, I ain't got the money.
You do now.
Hey, wait a minute. I ain't taking no charity from you, man.
I ain't giving you no charity. You're gonna work your tail off for this money. On the nose, pal.
I owe you a big one.
No, you don't. I think I'm getting the better end of this deal.
Thanks, Lou.
That's what it's for, pal.
Would you leave me?
No, never.
Then I won't go without you.
Oh, Mikey, this is different.
Grown-ups always say that.
Oh, Mikey. Look, I haven't even got a dime to call the doc, and I can't get you home safe with those guys chasing after me. Mikey, it's because we're friends I'm telling you this. You gotta go. We gotta split up. Oh, good boy. good, sonny. Oh, no, Mikey.
It's okay. I'm already dirty.
How did it come to this? My God, I'm digging in the trash for food. Mikey, come on, get back here.
I'm not looking for anything to eat, though.
What are you doing then?
I'm looking for this.
For that? Wow. That's a nice try, champ. But if those guys ever catch up with us, that ain't gonna do us much good.
You don't understand. I can take this to the grocery store and they'll give me a dime for it.
How'd you get to be so smart?
When we get the dime, we can call Doc Rick and he'll tell us how to get home.
Terrific. Come on, kid.
At least the room has stopped spilling.
Thank you.
Good. All right, I'll stay here with you, Father. You get back to Spencer.
Not yet.
We've wasted enough time here already, thanks to you.
Holly, I'm okay. I'll just take a few minutes rest and I'll be as good as new. You go ahead, darling.
Can we please stop this now?
What, take the money and run?
Why not? Grab what we can and get out of here. Father's health can't stand much more of this.
Of what? His daughter disappearing without a word? If he's under pressure, it's you that put him there.
That's not fair, Basil. You know, Father has a serious neurological ailment. My going away has nothing to do with this.
A neurological ailment? Is that what you call it?
Yes.
Yes, well, maybe you're right. But he also has a case of shaky nerves. Your father can't perform under pressure. I don't know. I never anticipated a problem like this in a town the size of Port Charles.
You underestimated Luke Spencer. I doubt you've ever been up against anyone as shrewd as he.
Oh, come on, Holly. I've been up against royalty. Did I ever tell you about my trip to the Scottish Highlands?
No, and I don't really care.
I stumbled into this 13th century castle and caught the Duke in a, so to say, compromising position with one of the local girls. I even had a photograph to prove it.
Had, Basil. Don't tell me you lost it.
Mm-mm. No, I sold it to him for £500,000. But enough talk of royalty. It's the peasantry that I'm concerned about. Worried about, even. Luke Spencer in particular.
Well, it's my father I'm worried about. He's ill. He should be in a hospital.
Absolutely not. Damn it, we should have retired him after the last assignment.
He's quite capable. He wouldn't be here otherwise.
Capable? Look at him. He can't even lift his head up. You call that capable?
I suppose we're just going to have to make the best of it, aren't we?
I loathe you, Basil.
You're charmed, I'm sure.
Well, I won't take another minute of your insult. I'm going
to
go.
Fine. Just try to return in a day or two, I don't think he can survive another one of your jaunts into the mountains. The last time nearly killed him.
Holly.
Father, I'm sorry. I didn't mean to upset you that much.
Darling, I know that. But it's not your fault.
What are we going to do?
We have to act quickly. Now that this Dante fellow can identify you, we no longer have the luxury of being able to pull the strings at our leisure. We have to anticipate every possibility.
Which
means?
And
be prepared to move out of here at a moment's notice.
We've got to free the money.
Immediately. We have to get that money out of the escrow account and into the corporate account.
That's my responsibility.
Well, not totally. Since you weren't able to persuade Spencer to release the money, I'm going to go to the Star tonight. Maybe he'll listen to me.
That's $750.
I thank you, sir.
Thank you. It was real nice service.
Sir?
Yes?
There is another small matter.
Oh, yeah, what's that?
And another $300 interment charges.
Wait a minute. You told me this was only going to be $800.
Well, so it was.
And so there's your $800.
Yes, sir, for the funeral. But it will cost $300 more to have the casket lowered into the ground and covered.
Now, you didn't say nothing about that.
Well, naturally, I...
Well, naturally, I assume this, weasel brain.
Sir, sir. I guess I misunderstood.
I guess you did.
I thought you wanted to give your mother a proper funeral.
I did give my mother a proper funeral.
Well, not quite. However, if what you want is more than you can afford, I suppose some adjustments could be made.
Well, yeah, well, what kind of adjustments?
Well, in charity cases of this kind...
I ain't no charity case,
now,
buddy.
There's nothing to be embarrassed about. Your mother will never know.
You like doing this for a living?
Burying people?
No, cheating them.
I beg your pardon.
Well, I don't like you cheating them, okay? Now, you're gonna get your $300 if it kills me.
Well, if it does, you know where to come.
Thank you, Claudia.
Well, I got here as quickly as I could. After you called, I grabbed a volunteer to man the desk at the clinic. What's up?
We're meeting Bert at his office. Someone from the FBI is going
to
be there.
Oh, they should be able to find Mike.
I've got to be at that meeting, and I didn't want to leave the house empty with nobody to answer the
Don't
phone.
Worry.
And Amy and Johnny are out looking.
So
and
you want me to house it?
Packey ever yes, if you wouldn't.
No
mind.
Problem at all.
Oh, nothing. We even called all his old gyms in New York, and nobody's heard of him or seen him for months.
Yeah, well, Packey's done a very good job of covering his tracks for some time. Amy, where's your bodyguard?
He does that.
Did you guys eat?
No, we didn't stop for lunch, but I'll make us some.
Oh, yeah, let me help.
Thanks.
You were right, Rick. About Packey. I finally had to admit it to myself. He was involved in doping me in my first fight.
Johnny, I'm really sorry.
No, I'm sorry. Because if I'd seen it earlier, Packey wouldn't have been here, and none of this would have happened. It's my fault that Mike's gone.
Next.
What?
We're all so busy running around taking the blame for what happened. It doesn't matter. It doesn't help. It doesn't matter how many people say it's my fault. It doesn't bring Mike back.
Hello.
Packey?
Packey?
Where are you?
Mike.
Packey, where are you?
Not far. Mike with him.
Is Mike with you?
Yeah, he's right here, Doc. Is he all right?
He's fine.
He's fine. He's fine. Packey, why?
Hey, Doc.
Doc. The thugs are following us. Probably Durnley's boys. They're after us. They're the chieftains everywhere.
Can you get over here?
No, we can't. They're watching your place, too.
All right, tell me exactly where you are. I'll call the police.
No cops. I just want to get Mike to you safe. And then after that, I'm going to disappear.
Packey, look, you can't do
this. Hey, Doc, these guys aren't kidding. If they even smell police, we're dead.
Packey, you can't keep running.
Oh, no.
Give me another choice.
We'll protect you. Now, what about Mike?
I'll bring him to you, but not there.
Right, you name your spot. I'll meet you anywhere.
Okay, someplace neutral, and you gotta come alone.
Can you get down to the waterfront? Look, you know the old abandoned warehouse down there?
Yeah, number 9, right?
Number 9, right.
Okay, that's a good idea. There's plenty of places to hide.
All right, I'm on my way.
Hey, no. I'll bring them to you after dark.
All right, I'll be there.
And Doc?
Yeah.
You come alone. You bring a friend. And we don't stand a chance.
What? I'll do what I have to get Mike back.
Yeah, I know.
You just deliver him to me safely.
I will. And Doc? Hey, I'm sorry.
Take care of Mike and yourself.
Is he really?
Mike is all right. He's all right.
All right.
What's going on?
I'm meeting Packey at the old warehouse, the one that's abandoned, right after dark. He's bringing Mike with him.
Why can't he come here?
There are a couple guys after him. He thinks it's Sterling's.
Okay, well, we just call the police.
No, Lesley, he wants me to meet him alone.
That's nonsense. I'm going with him.
And so am I.
No, you're not.
Why?
You want to endanger both their lives? He said he has to be alone.
I don't like this.
I don't like it either, but I think it's the way to get him back now. We're going to have to play it his way.
I've got to do something.
All right, go meet Bert and this fellow from the FBI and tell him what's happening.
Okay, what are you going to do?
I'm going down there now. I want to be there early in case they get there early.
Alone?
I don't have a choice. If a bunch of people show up, it's liable to scare them off, and I don't want to lose Mike now. All right?
Okay. Just be careful. sure hope this works. Well, we just have to see to it that it does, that's all. Claudia, you go back to the clinic. You two just stay here in case that phone rings.
Where are you going?
I'm going to tell Bert Ramsey what's happened.
Hey, buddy, get away from me.
Go. The World Security Bureau want me for 2 weeks.
Something big?
Well, it was a case that O'Reilly and I started some time ago. I want to wrap it up.
What do you want?
Well, you know me better than anyone. I'd be a liar if I said I wasn't tempted. I've got that urge again. Anyway, it doesn't hurt to stay in good with the Bureau. You never know, we might need a favor.
Sounds like we're gonna miss you around here.
Can you handle this oil mess on your own?
Oh, sure. All the more for me.
Hang on, wait a minute. Maybe I should hang around. Hang on, I'll reconsider.
No. You go ahead and have a good time. You may come back rich. Who knows?
But wait a minute.
Yes.
You might skip out of town with my share.
You never know that. But if I do, I'll send you a postcard.
What?
An expensive...
What?
So how are the mountains?
Quiet, restful, relaxing.
Hmm. Just like the star.
Look, I realize this is probably the most unimportant thing I've said of late, but I'll check with you before I go.
Right.
Right. Well, as you were, I'll see myself out.
See any wolves?
You know, there's only one wolf that visits that land.
He likes boats, too.
And go?
The wild ones.
Why don't you tell me where you were going?
You would have followed me?
No, I wouldn't.
No?
No. I wouldn't have let you go.
There's a special kind of magic in the air. You have to learn to accept me as I am.
Well, that goes both ways, baby.
I'm too used to being on my own to suddenly give it up. I ask permission every time I want to put a little distance between myself and the rest of the world.
Have I been crowding you?
Not you. All of this.
Striking oil cramps your style?
Not knowing, does. Everything's so unsettled. At least in the wilderness, you're dealing with familiar elements.
Oh, yeah. Mosquitoes, blistered heels, poison ivy, fellow woodsmen.
Those I can manage.
I noticed.
This is madness, though. One day we've got oil, the next day we haven't. I feel like a yo-yo. When's it going to end?
When we strike it rich.
If ever.
Look, Polly, come here.
Why don't we just sign it over to the Corso? Let them have the headaches. After all, they're the experts.
Okay.
You mean that?
Sure, I mean it. Right after I talked to Van Gelder.
Well, you won't be back for 10 days.
Well, what is the rush? The Corsos have waited this long and they can wait some more. It's so good to see you.
J. General Hospital will continue in a moment.